Hello and welcome back once again into this class. In this lecture, I am going to talk about Community Cloud, which is another variant of deployment-based model of cloud. In the subsequent files, we are going to look at some of the characteristics and some of the key ideas that underlie this variant of cloud computing. We will see why somebody will want to set up and use some Community Cloud in the subsequent files. This slide shows some of the key high-level properties of Community Cloud. The operating words here are community and, if you see, collaborative. A Community Cloud essentially is a collaborative effort where multiple organizations which may have shared interests, they come together to form a cloud wherein they share their infrastructure. Infrastructure could be their hardware. For example, they may share their computing resources, storage, etc. by using some cloud software. And in that sense, they are creating a cloud which can be used by the users or the participants coming from the members of this community. For example, a university can set up a cloud between its departments itself if it has large enough departments, and each one of those may have large number of computing resources. They themselves may set up a community cloud within the university, or it could be set up at a larger scale where multiple universities can collaborate if they are, let's say, working on some common projects, common research ideas. They may set up some infrastructure where it's easy for them to share their computing resources. So in that sense, there is some common shared interests there. These common concerns or shared interests could be, let's say, security, compliance, or the jurisdiction restrictions, etc. Security in the sense they are not comfortable, the members of the community which is coming together to form a community cloud. Let's say they may not be comfortable with the privacy policies of a public cloud. In that case, they may want to set up a shared infrastructure, and on top of it, using some cloud setup software, they create a community cloud. So in that sense, they are extending their capabilities. An individual university may not, let's say, have enough resources. Whereas if two or three of them come together where they are working on, let's say, a same set of projects or research ideas, then they may leverage their infrastructure collectively and yet provide better security and better privacy than probably what they may get from a public vendor. Now, one thing to note here is that the idea is pretty much sounding similar to what grid computing has. It's worthwhile to note that in grid computing also, you have multiple members coming together to share their infrastructure and solve their computing problems. But there are some key differences between grid and cloud computing. Typically, if you look at, I'm just trying to highlight so that we understand the concept clearly, especially in the context of a community cloud, that how the two things are different. So in case of a grid, typically the programming model is different, the business model is different from what you have in a cloud computing. In cloud computing, typically you have the entire control starting from your operating system and on top of it, whatever stack you might have. So in that sense, the programming is determined by the software stack that you may put together on top of your underlying infrastructure. We looked at platform as a service, and different platform as a service clouds can offer separate type of platforms for writing applications. Google App Engine, for example, lets you write web applications. And the programming model is such that it is geared towards allowing you to write web applications. If you compare it with grid computing, the programming model in grid computing is typically batch processed and job scheduled using message passing between the participating nodes. Nodes in the sense the machines that are cooperating to form a grid. And also the business model is different. In cloud, we have seen that there are several service models like infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, software as a service, etc. In grid computing, you do not have these kind of very crisp and clear service models. The business model there is typically incentives based, where the member organizations are sharing their infrastructure in lieu of some incentives. Incentives in the sense that they get to use the other members' infrastructure and also providing its own infrastructure to the others for leveraging. So it's a collective collaboration where each one is trying to come together to get a larger computing power, to form a big enough infrastructure so that they can solve larger, more complicated problems. Okay, so coming back to this list, What we see here is that the infrastructure of a community cloud need not be owned by and managed by the member organizations themselves. They can outsource it to some third party also for just the management tasks or just the hardware or the other infrastructural components. They may be procured or hosted by a third party. And another important aspect is that it removes a community cloud idea, removes the dependence on public clouds. Dependence in the sense that a public cloud guy may be offering you a particular type of service levels or quality of service, whereas the members of a community cloud can set up the different type of quality of service. And also, for example, they may use a different type of virtualization than what a public vendor may be providing. So in that sense, there is no restriction. You still have a lot of control. At the same time, you also have the benefits, but not to the same degree, the benefits that come with a public cloud. Now let's look at some of the key ideas. The operating word, as we saw, is community. Means that you're trying to work around some of the limitations that are posed by purely a private cloud or by a public cloud. So in the case of a private scenario, you may be limited by the resources that you own or that you can afford. Whereas in case of a public cloud, you may have issues related to security and privacy, etc. Whereas if you form a closed group of members who have some shared interests and share your resources so that you can address the issues that we just talked about. And similarly, you have some sort of openness in the sense that you remove the dependence on the vendors. Vendors may be giving you some quality of service, as we just saw. Some type of underlying virtualization may be there, whereas your own needs may require that you use a different type of virtualization, for example, due to performance reasons or whatever other reasons. So in that sense, you still have some control and there is individual autonomy that is still retained, that each of the member is expected to act there in their own interest. Since you have control of the underlying infrastructure in a more tighter manner in case of a community cloud, you may have failure handling implemented in a better way. You can handle the failures in a more graceful manner compared to the public cloud scenario. So if a member organization's nodes or infrastructure experiences some failures, so you may set up your community cloud such that these failures do not impact the other members' infrastructure as much. Whereas in case of a public cloud, that may not be necessarily the case, because typically in such kind of a scenario, the vendor is trying to optimize in the overall service. Overall means across the entire public cloud services that the vendor is offering, there is a desire to optimize the resources. So it may not be possible to have this kind of isolation of failures across the system. Whereas in case of community cloud, you may be having opportunities to do the failure handling in a more graceful manner. Now, even though you can have a customizable quality of service, which is different from a typical public cloud, at the same time, this comes with a cost. Since the members of a community cloud, they may have heterogeneous virtualization, let's say. And in those kind of scenarios, it's relatively difficult to implement a reasonable quality of service. So that can be a challenge. Implementing an acceptable quality of service can be a challenge in case of a community cloud. The reason being that each member may not have the equivalent amount of resources, or their resources may differ in their capacity, in their power, compute power, etc. Their network bandwidths may be different. Their virtualization technology stack may be different. So in that sense, the entire thing is somehow more heterogeneous than what a public cloud may have. So in that kind of an environment, ensuring uniform and acceptable quality of service can be difficult. So just to summarize this short lecture, what is community cloud? Community cloud is a collaborative effort between participating member organizations where they come together to share their infrastructure, computing infrastructure such as compute nodes, storage, etc. to set up a cloud platform where only the member organization can consume the resources from this kind of a cloud. That is, it is not available to any general public for subscription. And also there are some challenges involved, like ensuring acceptable and uniform quality of service is a little bit of a challenging task, since the member organization may have heterogeneous systems which they bring to the cloud, and making sure that a uniform and acceptable quality of service is delivered that can be a little bit more difficult than what you may have while you set up a public cloud or even a private cloud. Major driving factor is the shared concerns among the members that brings them together to form a community. So that is one of the key idea underneath the cloud community cloud. So let me highlight two more points. One from the consumer standpoint. It is natural to ask whether as a consumer you have to learn something new when you want to go for a community cloud versus a private cloud or a public cloud. So even though you may be writing web applications on a PaaS platform, now that PaaS platform may be exposed or deployed via a community or a private or a public cloud. So if you think about it, typically your development tasks are not as much determined or impacted by the deployment model, whereas they are more impacted by the service model. That is whether you are starting off with the infrastructure as a service cloud or as a platform as a service and so on. And when it comes to the provider side, in the provider side, there are certainly more differences, because in case of private cloud, whether you are setting up an infrastructure platform or a software as a service, you have much more control and you can make sure that certain hardware resources are behaving or configured in certain fashion. And you can also ensure, let's say, a common operating system for all the participating nodes, right? So in that sense, you have much more control in the private cloud case. Similarly, on a public cloud case, you may have the same scenario, but you may have to deal with scalability issues in a slightly different way. Because when you are offering the service as a public cloud, you are setting up a very large data center, right? Because it is your main business to offer the cloud services to general public. And in a private case, it may be just a small organization which is trying to optimize their data center resources by setting up as a private cloud. And so in that sense, there is some difference in how you manage the data center. Now, when you come to community cloud, there are yet another, there are other set of concerns. There you may be dealing with a heterogeneous underlying infrastructure, and you need to make sure that they are able to integrate in a nice way so that from the consumer standpoint, they get a uniform level of service. So it's important to keep both sides of the story in mind. That is, from the consumer side, what are the concerns, what are the challenges in each of these variants, and also from the provider side, that is when you're trying to set up one of these cloud variants, what are the challenges that you will be facing and what are the concerns that you need to keep in mind. So I think that's pretty much it in this short lecture, and in the next one we will see the last variant, which is hybrid cloud, and that will conclude all these three variants which were based on deployment models of cloud. Thank you.